What is up, everybody? My name is Bo Tyler. We're back in my studio again, and this week we are checking out a brand new expansion from Native Instruments called Backyard Jams. Now, my boy Mick from Native Instruments emailed me yesterday, and he said, if you like Catronata, you will like this one. Think vintage sounds, funk and soul influences, and big synth sounds. Now, I had no idea who Catronata was, and oh my God, so good. I'll put a link to their music, his music, their music down in the description. If you don't know them, check it out. Dope. But now let's get to the task at hand and find out if Mick from Native Instruments is a liar. All right, so what I'm gonna do today is open up Backyard Jams in my machine. Plus, I'm gonna go through every single drum group so you know exactly what this thing is loaded with. I'm going to set all of my favorites so we can see how many of the drum groups I found were worth saving. And then finally, any drum groups I run across that really inspire me or that I think are particularly interesting, I'll put on the 16 pads and just kind of see how it feels so I can show you how it works, at least from a finger drumming perspective. Okay, so that's interesting. This is just a drum kit. It's called the Drum Sum Kit. I'm gonna load it in here because I want to see what else is in there. That should be on. There's a sound effect in there and a bass. Two cool sound effects. Let me just kind of tap on this for a second. This should probably be in choke group one, so it's. That way, if you're a little off on your timing. Very cool. All right, let me erase that. We'll keep going through the browser here. The Elevate Kit. Yeah, just for the drums. Just for the chords. Just for the everything. That was the far out kit. Nice. Yes, please. Bass kick and snare are on point. That is Nintendo 64 lobby music, and I am here for it. I'm gonna have to like raise my bar. I think I've saved just about everything so far. Let me look. I'm not a Native Instruments shill, I swear to God, but yeah, I've saved everything so far. It's all good. I don't know what to make of those drums. I'm sure they're great, but I wouldn't know how to use them. But that bass, all day. So that's the type of music I would listen to. And as a whole, it's really, really good. But there's no individual instrument that I'm in love with. Is that weird? Does that make any sense? I don't know. Tell me I'm crazy in the comments. More video game lobby music. Does anybody remember Pilot Wings on Nintendo 64? That's what that's making me think of. I'll leave that one off. Snare. So this is when it's hard for me to be objective as a songwriter and a producer. I feel like that instrumentation could suit a voice very, very, very well. But it would depend on what the voice is doing. It's completely non-objectionable. It gives off a vibe without being so memorable that it steals the show from what an incredible vocalist would do. But as someone who half the music I make is instrumentals, I tend to want really interesting musical elements that are just as interesting to me, at least, as a vocal is. So I dig that. It's a great vibe. I just don't think I would use it. I don't think I would use it correctly. This is called the LA Nights Kit, and feels like all of my nights in LA. Love those drums. That was the Lilac kit. Really love those drums, actually. Dig the vibe. Yeah, I gotta save that one. That feels like an Anomaly sort of song. If you don't know who Anomaly is, I'll put his link in the description. You probably know who Anomaly is. Those are the most early 90s drums I've ever heard, just for nostalgia. Even if I never release it, that's the sort of thing I would come in to my studio when I'm not filming or I'm not making song to release, and I'm just making songs for me. Two for me, one for you all. That's how it works. That's a cool vibe, it's just not my vibe. But if you know me and you know my music, you know that's exactly my vibe. So, nice. Don't even know what I would call that. I'd listen to it, I wouldn't even know how to make it. Obviously, I'm saving that, but to whoever programmed that sequence, I mean, how do we do it? It was awesome. That's my point, is that I liked it. Good job! To my friends at Native Instruments, please tell me who arranged these sequences because I need to listen to their music. They're on their game on this one. And by the way, don't make dope sequences, but don't make sequences that are better than what I'm gonna make. I mean, kudos for raising the bar, but whoever made these, seriously, like, I don't know how that works, too. I've never asked my friends at Native Instruments about this, if it's one guy or a group of guys. I'm gonna find out, I'm gonna let you know. It might be an interesting short video. I'm gonna hang off. Once I've exhausted all my favorites, I tend to come back through and listen to the others and find like five new favorites. We'll make that a late loved B-side. Just so I can remember to grab that bass. Yes. Yes. All of it. I mean, come on. So this is Sound Effects 1 kit. Here's Sound Effects 2 kit. So I don't use sound effects like this, but I know a lot of people do, and I don't not use them. I don't not use them. Whatever, you know what I mean. I don't not use them. I don't even remember what I meant anymore. Oof. I don't use sound effects because I don't know how to use them properly. For those of you who do, let's load these up and show you what's in here. What do we call these? I'm going to call them zingers. That's not a zinger, I don't know what it is. Call that a bleepy bloop. I'm gonna call that a 9-year-old saying, come at me, bro. I'm gonna call that a cricket who drank too much cough syrup. I'm not gonna say what I was just thinking. Somebody sampled Jeopardy. Don't tell me that wasn't sampled from Jeopardy. Don't tell me that wasn't sampled from the Daily Double. That was the most interesting one to me. Yeah, so that's kit one of two. Let's keep going here to the Showtime kit. For the drums, baby. Just want that second snare. So I know that's like when you're just taking it for one element, but all I need is a bit of inspiration. Just because I pull a group doesn't mean I'm going to make a song with that group. I'm going to take the elements I like, I'm going to mix and match, and I'm going to do very little work and take all of the credit when people say they love the song. You know, it's kind of the drill. This is all ARPs. Let's load this in and see what this sounds like. This is a little bit different. I dig these. So that for a half a second, you can make people get anxiety about whether they just got a text message, a phone call, or an email. That's what that's called. Nintendo. You just leveled up. The super attractive blonde-haired, pink-dressed NPC just gave you a smooch on the cheek, and you had digital feelings. Super cool, but would be super difficult to use because of all the tones in it. Super difficult for me. I don't know, someone make a video on why I'm wrong and that those are awesome so that I can learn a new thing. Cool. You could pitch that out into an entire song, especially if you were just like playing the 1, the 4, and the 5. And then maybe like a 5 over 5 chord, which would be like, ooh, or even better. Yeah, just lift that 3 chord to major. You know, like in C major, you'll often hear an E minor lifted to an E major to really rise up, especially if you're playing it, you know, like in the minor version, like so A minor, and you were going back to the A minor 1 chord. So you could really get, you know, reasonably 4 chords out of that that wouldn't seem weird at all. Yeah. Cool, so that had a lot of the samples in it. That's the special vocal kit. Like I've said before, I love all the drums. I'm gonna save all the drums that Native Instruments puts on expansion packs that are dope. But if they made an entire expansion of only melodic kits or only like perks, I mean, that would be as cool as a plugin just because it would be so usable, you know? Just in case I need to ever make someone feel like they're at a 90s house party driving to a 90s house party in their mom's station wagon. Which I mean in the absolute best way. I gotta load that just to see how that bass actually operates. Put that right here on sampler, move that over to one shot. I like that these are already in choke groups. Very nice. Yeah. God, that felt good. That is a good kit. Love that. Let me load that one in and see what's in there. Yes! Ugh, I'm saving too many kits. I just want those guitars, and I realize now it would have been easier to simply show you the kits that I didn't save. That'd have been a lot quicker. For the sake of not having option anxiety, there's already a kit that sounds a bit like that to me. Maybe I'll find a place for it in the future. That would be all the bass and drums I would need for a whole song. That's my John Mayer face. How to do? Not my tempo. Bass and drums, man. That's it. Okay. So we had 44 kits total in Backyard Jams. Let's see how many we saved. 28. 28 out of 44. So not the most I've ever saved. And I would say that 4 or 5 of those were legitimately for one instrument. So let's split the difference in case it was arbitrary. And we'll say that 25 out of 44. It's really good because I paid like $50 for one drum pack before. Haven't you? Haven't we all? Don't tell your wife or your husband. That's how all of this comes to a screeching halt. Keep your secrets. It is the absolute cornerstone of a healthy marriage. And my door just popped and I thought my wife heard that and I was about to duck under this desk and hide. Make sure. Let me check. Whew. We're safe. We're still here. We're all still here. Anyway, so yeah, Mick was not lying. That was friggin' dope. And he was right. I do indeed dig that. So I was thinking about this earlier and I've decided I'm going to start rating these plugins or expansions or whatever it is I review on a new system called the Bowtie system. And I give this very awesome machine expansion 4 out of 5 bow ties. I hope you agree. Anyway, I want to say seriously though, thank you all so much for watching. My name is Bo Tyler. I make music. Please do not forget to create something every day. And as always, if you like this content, if you like what I'm doing, I don't need your money. I just need your unwavering and completely devoted love and loyalty. Not really. I just need you to hit the like button and maybe subscribe and even, I don't know, hit the notification bell. Either way, we're still friends. I'm sure you're neat. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you soon. Peace.